going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and I know a lot of you guys are pumped for this one. So you can now mine ZEPH at Unminable and get paid out in any freaking coin that you wish. That means that saves going to an exchange yourself. It saves you downloading your own ZEPH wallet. A lot of you guys don't care. Keep in mind that this is 100% sell pressure if you're getting paid out in another coin. Now, if you are using Unminable in the first place, you probably don't care about that, but I figured I would point that out. Another thing is this will only work if you use reference code Rabid. I'm just kidding. You will get a discount at the pool for using my code to help support the channel and myself, but you can just use your own reference code and get the same thing. So, you know, use mine if you want to support me, or just use your own by going to the referral tab up top once you begin mining. So regardless, we're going to look at this, and right now we can see that ZEPH has been added to get paid out in. It has also been added and replaced Monero. So if we go up to CPUs up here, there's only one option. That was random X. And then whenever you were mining this, you were always mining XMR or Monero. Now, ZEPH has been seeing major pumps lately, and it runs on the same algorithm as Monero. So you can see the announcement is right here. If you were mining with the random X algorithm, you may have noticed that the rewards for all coins have increased by at least 6X. I believe ZEPH is, you know, as of this week, it's gone up like, I don't know, it's like 10 or 12x or something. I think we're sitting around $51, $52. It used to only be like freaking $2 for the longest time. XMR hasn't really been that profitable, really. You know, it's making a little bit, but never really too much in terms of fiat value and stuff like that. But they changed it out. They got rid of Monero altogether and moved it all over to ZEPH. So you see a hash rate increase of profits here by at least 6x. Over the past hours, we've switched from XMR to ZEPH internally, which is currently more profitable than XMR based random X mining. Miners don't have to take any action. This update is effective immediately. Enjoy. So anyone that was already mining, try, or at least thought you were mining Monero, or at least a random X algorithm, Monero is no longer being mined, and it's all coming in from ZEPH. Now, this also works vice versa. If you got some GPUs, which combine all these other algorithms here, as well as Kaspa ASICs, for an example, you can also just reverse it around, mine these other coins, whatever hardware you have that supports them, and then get paid out in ZEPH if you want to get in on this latest pump as well. So here I'm going to show you how to actually mine the RandomX algorithm with your CPUs. I'm going to swap this over, and we're going to choose, I don't know, we'll go with Kaspa for this one, I guess. We're going to mine ZEPH and get paid out with Kaspa, because that's the other coin that a lot of people are talking about lately to see huge pumps leading into the bull run. And obviously, you know, we're going to see what happens, and you don't have to buy yourself a Kaspa ASIC or anything like that, because you already got CPUs at home and not have to worry about any KS Pros, KS3s, KS1s, and you're probably going to be making pretty close to a KS0 anyway, depending on the CPU that you actually have. So they actually have a calculator down in the corner here. Depending on the coin you're mining, it'll tell you based on your hash rate. So I do have about 528 kilohash on my CPU farm for RandomX, and that's estimating about 813 Kaspa coins per day. So if we actually go into hashrate.no, a KS2 is doing about 393. So this is like a little over two KS2 miners on my CPU farm in order to get Kaspa. So that's pretty good. Obviously here, this is not overclocked, so you are getting a bit more if you do run the overclocking software on your Kaspa miners. But we can see that we're earning, you know, just like Kaspa ASICs here on my CPU farm. So we're going to start things off in Windows here, and then we'll move over to Hive-OS. But any algorithm that XMRig does support, this is the miner I recommend, XMRig. So we're going to be rocking this one. Once you click on it, obviously I'll have a link down in the description. And then just download the Windows version, whether it's MSVC or the GCC version. Now, I've tried both out. They both always seem to do about the same, but some people do say one outperforms the other on RandomX and one outperforms the other on Ghost Rider. I still have a lot more testing to do, but so far for RandomX, I haven't found a difference in hash rate, at least on my 7950X. So once you get that download extracted, if you're a CPU miner, you've probably been running this for a while, you already have it. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click one of my previous bat files here. I'm going to copy this over and then just paste it in and rename this over to Unminable. So I'm just going to go unminable. So bam, so we have our unminable dealio here. So if you don't know what the how to set up the bat file, it does have little branches here where you can just say start, test, and you know, examples. Here's solo mine example, solo example, solo mining ocean. We're just gonna find out where the default one is. I probably just renamed it. So there will be a default here and it kind of tells you what to go over, but here you'll see everything right for yourself. So here we got xmrig.exe. This is what's telling your miner to actually start running at first. And then these are all the parameters we got to adjust so that we're using the proper stratums and proper pools and everything on xmrig to get paid out in our Kaspa. So right now we can see it's dash A here. We do have RX/0. This means this is the algorithm that you're using. So in this case, we are mining the random X algorithm and unminable on their own. They're pretty much pointing to ZEPH anyway because they eliminated XMR. So here is dash O. This is your stratum. So this is what we need to find for unminable. So in order to find your actual stratum, you know, you can pick it up top here or just click on CPU, click on random X. It's all brought up here. But here's the stratum. This is a global stratum right here, rx.unminable.com. This will just then find the closest stratum for your PC. And then here's your SSL port if that's what you want to use, or your TCP port. So in this case, I'm just going to click on it. It's going to copy it. And I'm going to use port 3333. So I'm going to bring up our bat file again. I'm just going to rewind here, get rid of that, delete, and then put in port 3333. Now we have to put in our wallet address. This is going to be our Kaspa wallet address because we're getting paid out in Kaspa. So make sure you use whatever you do plan to get paid out in by presetting it on unminable. And by presetting it, that's simply this right corner up here. You can see I'm on Kaspa. Click that if you want Dogecoin, click Dogecoin and so on. But use the address that you plan on getting paid out in with whatever coin that is supported here. All right, so I copied my Kaspa address and here you can see how it works. So this is the coin we're getting paid out in, Kaspa. So I'm just gonna delete all this so you can see exactly what's going on, including my worker name so I can add that in so you guys can just do it step for step. So as we change it, this will change. In this case, it's Kaspa. If it's Doge, it's Doge. Again, remember, if you click on the top right there, it'll tell you the coin you're choosing. So we're gonna go KAS for Kaspa. We're going to go our semicolon here. Now we're putting in our Kaspa wallet address. That is that right there. And now we're going to add our worker name. So in this case, it is Rabid, WS for workstation. Now we're going to add a hashtag, and then code Rabid is your referral. Now, if that's if you plan on using my referral, you can use your own referral and as well gain the reduction in pool fees. But using hashtag Rabid there will actually grant me a little bit of your pool fees and helps out the channel. So regardless, you can just use your own if you want. And this is not in here by default, but if you plan on setting threads in XMRig using the bat file version, you just put a dash dash threads equals 30. Once you're all done that, simply hit the file and then the save button. Now, if this is your first time downloading XMRig, you have it all set up, make sure you right click on XMRig, go to properties. You always want to run your CPU miners as an administrator so you get the extra bonus hash by using huge pages and MSR mods and stuff. So you can see run this program as administrator, click that on. If it is off, apply it, hit OK. And now you just come into whatever it is we name. So we got to find our bat file here, unminable, double click that. It's there, it's asking for admin privileges. Hit yes, it should connect and be all good. So here we can see rx.unminable.com. Port 3333 is loading up and now it'll begin mining ZEPH and paying us in Kaspa. Okay, so it did take about 4 or 5 minutes and we were detected at the pool. Obviously, our hash is a lot higher than what it's currently saying. It will take about an hour or so till you get your full hash rate at the pool here. We can see right now my 7950X is hashing around 17.2 kilohash with a max of 17.3 kilohash. So looking pretty good. We are now detected. Worker is there. Now, if you want to just use your own referral, as I mentioned earlier, at this point, you'll be able to see it. If you click on referral here, you'll be able to see your link. Then you can just simply copy this and put it into your own wallet address and get the reduction on pool fees again, or you can just use mine, hashtag Rabid. Well, that pretty much wraps up Windows. I am now going to jump into Hive-OS. So first thing, if you have multiple farms, ASIC farms, GPU farms, CPU farms, depending how you have everything named, choose the farm where you're going to set it up. In this case, it's with the CPUs. So here you can see all my CPU rigs. You're going to want to add your wallet. So simply click on wallets here add wallet, and then we type coin and ticker. Just go Kaspa, click on that, enter your address, name it any gobbledygook that you want to name it. Just make sure you know what it is. In my case, I'm going to be using my Tangent wallet. Now we're going to go into our workers. So once we're here, we can see all our workers back in the flight sheets. You didn't have to go to workers, but we're going to flight sheets now, and we're going to select our coin. We're going to go Kaspa, Cas, and now it automatically comes up to all the Hive-on stuff. So we're going to change our wallet here to the Tangent wallet. This is what I did name it, or my Kaspa node, or just my normal Kaspa. This was the web wallet, I believe. But I'm going with the hard wallet here, Tangent. Click on that. Now we're going to select our pool. Unminable is not in here yet. It's brand new, just released, just announced. We're going to configure this in the miner. Now we're going to go to the miner here and scroll down to XM rig, or simply type in XM and it should come up. So we want XM rig new. Click on that and then name our flight sheet before we do any of the parameters. So I'm just going to go Unminable video is what I'm naming this flight sheet. Now we're going to go set up miner config, and this is where all the magic happens. So some pretty simple things right off the get-go here. We want to turn on our CPU. That's key number one. This is the biggest mistake everyone forgets in Hive-OS, is you must turn on your CPU. Then simply go to the eye, click that, huge pages, we want that on. This gives us some hash boost, and then wallet template, we'll get to that in a minute. Select our algorithm. We are going with RX, so we're going random X here, RX XMR. Yes, that is what we need. So now we're going to need our wallet template and our pool URL. This is what we're going to get from the Unminable website again. So we're just going to click on Unminable here. I want to click on Kaspa. We're already on it anyway. Click on CPU. Random X. So here again, we're going to click this. It's going to copy it, rx.unminable.com, and port 3333. Again, that's me. I'm using TCP. You can use SSL port 443 if that's what you choose. And now we're going to come into pool URL. Bam. Semicolon 3333. Now we need our wallet worker template. So we're going to do this. But in front of it, remember, we do have to add this right here, Kaspa. So we're going to come back in, capital letters, K-A-S, your semicolon, and then at the end again, reference code, and then Rabid. Again, you can only use yours if you want as well, but I recommend using mine and saying thank you. Anyway, we're going to apply changes here, create that flight sheet, let it do its thing. We're going to scroll back up, go into our workers here. Now I'm going to go into rig one, flight sheet. And now we're just going to hit that flight sheet and send it to the moon. If you have a bunch of saved flight sheets here, the latest flight sheet you always made will be the first one under the stars, or you can start and it'll be up in the stars with you. So now I'm just going to send that to the moon with the rocket ship like so. And we are now beginning to mine Kaspa while we're mining Zeph, getting paid out in Kaspa at Unminable. So I just did a quick SSH into my rig here, and we can see that we are connected to the pool, rx.unminable.com, port 3333. We're using our Kaspa wallet address. We're mining Zeph, and we're getting paid out in Kaspa, you know, more than what a Kaspa ASIC is currently paying us. So that is pretty crazy. You don't have to go buy a Kaspa ASIC anymore if you got CPUs sitting at home. All right, so we can see the workstation is already picking up a little bit of hash rate, as well as our Hive-OS rig is now detected at the pool. Again, it only took like 3 to 4 minutes or so it was pretty fast. So that is how you mine Zeph on your CPU, which is exploding in profitability. The fourth largest proof of work network in emissions and paid miners. It recently passed Ethereum Classic. Next on the list to pass is Dogecoin, which is crazy right now. So things are looking good, and you now have the ability to mine Zeph and get paid out in pretty much any coin that you want. Well, that pretty much does wrap this up. You should be CPU mining Zeph and getting paid out in pretty much any coin that you want at this point. I do want to thank Unminable for sponsoring this video. And they do claim that they're probably one of the most profitable pools for Zeph right now. Now, I can't confirm that because I haven't tested myself. But I can confirm that, you know, at least when I was mining script and stuff. Because what they do here is they actually proxy out to other pools, so that maybe that's why we're seeing some hash rate spikes happen on some pools at times. But they have their internal pool as well as a proxy going out to other pools just to keep rewards and everything pretty consistent. So that's kind of a cool thing that they're doing there. But I can confirm, at least when you're mining script with like the L7 and the mini Doge 2s and stuff, that this script pool was the most profitable pool when I compared it versus some of the larger script pools out there as well. So they are doing good things here. I just can't confirm it on Zeph alone until I do more testing. Anyway, guys, thank you for checking out this video. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.